When it comes to patterning components, one frequent issue that we face is this. How do we change only one instance of the pattern? In this video, we will be discussing two scenarios of patterned components and how we can change only one instance in each of these scenarios. Before we begin, go to Preferences, General, Design, and uncheck Active Component Visibility if it is checked. This will toggle off the translucency of non-active components. It makes it easier to see all components regardless of which component is active. In the first scenario, we will be looking at a pattern that is produced using the top-down design approach. In this case, all components will be created within the same file. Starting with a fresh file, go to Create, New Component, and create the starting or seed component. This will be just a basic cylinder. Let's perform a simple rectangular pattern. For type, select components. Let's try adding a fillet to the third instance. Activate that component and add a fillet. All components change. It does not matter whether you try this on the seed component or the patterned instances. Both methods will cause changes in all three components. It is important to recognize that these are all the same component. All three share the same color code. Looking at their respective labels, the segment before the semicolon is a component's name. They all share the same component name. The number after the semicolon refers to the instance. Since all three are the same component, changing one of them will change all of them. Let's remove the fillet. Let's say that I only want to add a fillet to the third instance. Right-click on this particular component and copy. After that, right-click on the top level and paste new. This produces a component that is independent of the original. Click to place this new component in the exact same location. Notice that this new component has been automatically renamed. This new component overlaps with the third instance of the previous pattern. Let's hide the previous component. Activate this new component and add the fillet. This fillet does not apply to the previous instances. If we activate a seed component and change the diameter, notice that the component created by the Paste New option remains unchanged. So changes neither flow downstream or upstream between the original seed component and the component that is produced by the Paste New option. In this second scenario, we have a component that has been saved out as a separate file. This can be accessed from the data panel. We have a fresh file open. The plan is to use this existing file as a seed component in this new file. This is known as a bottom-up design approach or the distributed design approach. Let's drag this into the new file. Click OK to put it into its default position. In this case, you will see a chain link icon. This means that this component already exists as a file in your database, as opposed to the previous scenario, where the component was actually created within the new file. Let's create a pattern. Editing of components is slightly different in this scenario. If we hover over a component, we will see a pencil icon appear. Clicking on that would allow us to edit in place. Let's add a fillet and confirm. As with the previous scenario, all components change. Let's remove the fillet. To do that, we need to perform the edit in place again. As in the previous example, suppose that we only want to apply the fillet in this third instance. Right-click on the component and copy. When you right-click on the top level, notice that there is no option to paste new. So the paste new option is not available to us in this case. So here is my recommendation. Make sure that the top level is activated. Create a new component. Edit the component that you need to change. Look for the body in the bodies folder. Right-click and copy. And the edit in place. Activate the new empty component. Right-click and paste. Confirm to place the body in the same location. Let's hide the previous component. With the new component still active, let's add a fillet. This does not change the other two components. Let's try to change the diameter of the seat component. Again, perform an edit in place. Locate the sketch and change the diameter. You can see that the copied component changes. So it seems that although changes do not flow upstream from the copied component to the original component, they do flow downstream. Just a word of caution here, I have observed some unpredictable behavior in this workflow. After trying this multiple times, I have noticed that changes do not always flow downstream. In other words, changing the diameter of the original component does not always change the diameter of the copied component. Do try this and let me know your experience.